survived the castle.
Hello? Can someone help me, please? Hello? No! Morning Lord, help me! Hello? Someone here?
Survived the castle. I didn't.
What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Untold Odyssey's Curse of Strahd. For the first time in 2023 now.
Hey guys. Yay!
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 Time.
Yay.
How about
Happy
you?
New Year.
Say yay,
yeah,
it's
happy
my
new
birthday.
Year.
Yay.
Wait, is it?
No, not at all. My birthday's all the way in June. But last Friday was my girl's birthday.
Mm.
Oh, wait, really?
Nice.
Okay, I forgot our birthdays are a day apart. Yeah.
They
happy belated birthday
they
to them.
They are officially 2 years old and driving me up a fucking wall, driving Sarah up a fucking wall.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. No, it's bad. It's bad news.
That's what kids are good at.
No, for real. Spanish Bears.
So, welcome back for the new year. Happy New Year, everybody. Hope you had a wonderful Christmas. Happy New Year to you, chat. If you haven't hung out with us at for last week, with it being so close to the new year, we decided to go ahead and push one week back. So I think it's been like a month and a half at this point.
Well,
since we played, you know, we've got I think two games in, and then we took a massive break on him. Poor Miss. I'm sorry, boss.
It's just your luck.
But hey, man, you're back. We are all back. We're ready to do some things. We are ready to see what happens. With that, we will do a small little recap for what happened in 2022. All right. Very, very quickly. You guys ran through the Death House, right? You were able to do things. You were able to kill Walter, demonic baby, right? Remember the demonic baby?
Right. Sadly.
So you guys went through there. You were able to find your way into town after meeting Strahd. Strahd offering some of you some power, forcing power on some others. Right. Which you guys recently have found out that a certain masked individual may have some fangs now, right, and has no problem showing them, with the exception of Irina, who he's still choosing to hide from just a little bit, right, because she would probably try to slaughter his ass, but that's besides the point.
Yep.
So you guys also met Ishmark. Ishmark sent you guys into a cave to go be able to get her a gem for a specific pendant. Earning you the trust of both Ishmark and of Isabel? Is that what
Irina?
Irina, I'm sorry. Irina Indervich.
I was gonna say Vondersmoot, so
Vondersmoot.
Sounds great. Either way.
So you guys were able to hang out with Irina. And then after that, I came back, went back into the church, found yourself that the priest was keeping his son down below, trying to figure out how to turn him back human if there was any choice, because he was infected with the vampiric curse. So, on having no way of being able to do that, and Cappy being a vampire himself, was able to curb his cravings, at least, and set him on the path. Very, very, very nice job from Kami over there. After that,
how that plays out.
Yeah, after that, you guys did go ahead and decide to leave, making your way to the Hangman's Gallows, where Kane actually saw himself, I believe it was Kane at least, saw himself hanging from the gallows, noose tightening around his neck. And then upon investigation, finding out it was just a ghoul's trick, and Strahd was fucking with you all as zombies and everything else came out to provide entertainment in the way of battle. Crossing the bridge and crossing a bridge, you guys came across a set of basically walking thorn bushes. Who proceeded to stab you guys, and you started to turn into bark creatures yourselves. A special shout out to Kane, who got himself stabbed in the ass, and you know had to get the barbs out of his ass cheek.
Yes, I did.
He's like, oh yeah, let me get that flavor in there. I'm like, if you want to, bro. At that time, he had no idea that he would be turning his ass bark, literally. His ass cheek barked. The fuck?
There's a whole meeting to barking spiders.
Yep. So after that, you guys did actually end up meeting, I'm just calling him X, right? So... X had been attacked by the same creatures. Unfortunately, his entire arm has been taken over, and trying to peel that off has caused him a great deal of pain. So he is able to keep it at bay using some magic, and is even using a portion of it as a spellcasting focus, which is kind of nice. But it is something that, if he does not find a cure to, may take him over entirely. After that, Arena got taken by a giant were-raven, whom you literally, who you found out later, would be named Feather. And then took you guys to your first encounter with a smart enemy, which did not go well, unfortunately. The hacks, proceeding to try to talk shit to Arashi and try to break her Holy Spirit. She stood her ground, and unfortunately, it cost in the end that the hags now, instead of just marking her, would mark three of her companions and leave the monster hunter and the holy person to make the decision, let their friends die or do the evil deeds themselves. And that is where we are at currently. And that is where I will turn it over to you guys. Having taken a long rest and founding some a shit ton of magic items, right? As you guys rolled like 40 freaking dice for extra items at the end. I'll turn it over to you guys.
Look, guys.
I'm giving myself advantage. On my next throw.
Uh-huh.
That was a lot of stuff. That was a big recap.
Yeah.
So, what's the plan here, guys? Because now we're marked. And this can't end well, any way we look at this.
Looks like we're killing some kids, or bringing some kids, or dead kids to these people.
Yeah.
And getting a fang.
Yo, can those birds that we killed count? Like, you know, like the dead body outside?
I don't know if they can return one that's already been turned.
So,
I mean, she didn't specify. She just said bring three kids.
I mean, you're not wrong there.
I'm just saying, if push comes to shove, Arashi, you couldn't make that hard decision before. Are you going to be able to make it next time?
Listen.
With our lives on the line?
Listen, I can't break my vows like that. I'm not going to. I'm sorry. Like, I can save y'all. No?
We're just going to send Arashi off on her quest by herself for a couple days. And then we're going to go do another quest for a couple days on our own. I mean, I didn't say that out loud.
No, out of character, great. In character... what does that even mean?
Nothing.
Means I don't want to die.
I mean, fair. Means
the less you know, the better.
Yep.
No, I'll take it. I'll take
it. If you don't know.
Yep, you know what? You're right. We're good.
Ignorance.
I value my life too much to die to some hag.
Ignorance at times can be helpful.
Shit.
I won't call it bliss, but I'll say it's helpful at times. In certain situations.
Look, as long as you don't tell me what you're going to do, we're good. That burns me.
Good, don't ask questions.
We won't tell you answers.
Yeah.
So, well, okay, now I got to ask a question. Do y'all want to go and try and get this tooth?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, we'll get the, I'm hoping, easy one out of the way.
I'm off.
I'm hoping we'll get the easy one out of the way, and then we'll figure out.
You may be off, but we can still hear you, bud.
We can still hear your cheesy bread. Hold on,
we can hear your cheesy bread, my dude.
you may be off camp, but we can still hear you, bud.
Oh, dude, that was so funny. I was like, is he talking to us?
No, my wife made stuffed peppers and four cheese Texas toast.
Oh, that sounds great. You're not going to share with us? Kev?
Well, I tell you what, when they make it so that I can stick it right into the monitor and y'all can get some.
Thank you.
But until then.
No.
Okay, fair enough.
My wife made cornbread tamale casserole, so I can't complain. This shit is delicious.
Yeah, I saw the pictures.
It's delicious.
It looked good. All right, guys. So, Irina.
Where are we going to this tooth? Where are we gotta get?
It's at the lake down there, that we can see from the.
Isn't it like a fisherman or something?
She didn't specify, really. It was like a hold on.
I say, please refer to the notes.
Yeah,
with a tooth around his neck or something like that. It was like a mm-hmm. necklace with a tooth on it.
Was it in fact a tooth around his neck?
So I guess let's go to the lake and see if we can find this guy. What time of day is it? Like, I know we just
long rested.
Is it morning next day?
So you guys, actually, I need to take a look. Actually, I think I put timekeeping in your thing. Because you were only 3 hours after the fact of waking up, and you guys woke up, and it was like super early, so it was like 9 o'clock. You did a battle, let's call that 10 o'clock. You walked your butt upstairs and pretty much took 8 hours after that fact, so you're probably looking about 6 p.m. in the evening.
I have no desire to go out at night.
Any books to read?
Maybe we should, though, because I'm feeling a little weak after that rest, and I think that has something to do with the mark.
Yeah, so...
Same.
Yeah. Damn, we're in a dilemma then, because... Wait, we're still, like, Straw was telling us not to go out. I mean, if y'all want to chance it, I'm down.
I mean, Straw told us a lot of shit.
Okay, I know, but last time we were out, they tried to take Irina.
I know you got things for vamps.
Shut the fuck up, Tommy. Shut the fuck up.
We don't need to listen to everything he says.
On a side note, as your DM, I will allow, if you guys want to wait until morning, that may not be a long rest, since you've already taken one. We'll just extend your long rest till morning at this point, if that's what you're looking to do. Now, I'm not saying that time limits aren't a thing or anything like that. All I am saying is that if you guys want to extend past this for later because you do not want to go out at night, I completely understand.
Well, if we're going to do that, we can do some busy work in the meantime.
I'm down for that too.
Mm-hmm.
Ingredients, arrow crafting, that sort of shit.
All right, Mr. Gunter, what you thinking?
Well,
Mr. Gunter had nothing to say. Are y'all down? That's one person that's down.
Yeah, that's fine.
That sounds good.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, cool. All right, what's Irina gonna be doing?
Sitting in a corner crying about her nightmares.
Damn. Okay.
That shit was terrible, bro. You have no idea.
No, yeah, I remember. Yeah, I remember you saying it was. Oh. Well, I'll try and talk to Irina and comfort her, I guess, while we pass the night away. It's paused, so I can't move.
Yeah, I'm gonna see if there's any books at all. Especially those that have arcane sigils.
So I will just give it based off of your passives that you're not finding a lot here. What you will find is a lot of evidence of children being brought here and used to cook the pastries, the dream pastries. It's the best way for me to put it. It's some real Hansel and Gretel shit going on in here, is all I'm saying.
Yeah.
Like some real Hansel and Gretel shit. You also will hear quite a few birds coming around.
Yeah. Are we going to stay here? Because we don't know when those witches will come back.
I mean, shit, where else are we supposed to go? To be honest, I mean, and plus Irina's over here, like, look at her. She's not doing too great. Hey, Irina.
We also have to worry about Strahd's carriage driver.
Yeah,
that's true. But, There's so much. I mean, hold on. Thinking about it, right?
Can I get the world map to take a look at what's around us?
Ooh. So, if you remember right, you only know what you guys have seen. You never actually had a map.
Well, no, I know that. I'm asking you.
I will know what we've seen.
But, yeah.
I will do this for you. How about that? And even then, that gives you a lot more than what you would have actually seen, is all I'm saying.
Oh, so I guess the lake is over here.
Yeah, the lake would be over in that general direction.
Okay. But we don't know that.
No, we do, because we saw it from where we were. She told us.
Yeah.
She told you to follow the path, and that would bring you to the lake. Continue on the path. On a side note, here's what I can tell you. It sounds like RJ. So I'm going to try to start limiting you guys, FYI. Before I tell you kinds of roles or anything, all right, this is what I'm going to start doing as a DM. I'm going to try to limit the, oh, he failed. Here, let me try. Oh, he failed. Oh, here, let me try. Right? I'm going to start limiting that things. So it's going to be a group, right, decision on who does what before I even tell you this is the role that you are going to be using. All right. So if you want to assist someone, yep, you're not even going to know, is it a sleight of hand check? Is it an acrobatics check? You're not going to know, right? You're going to tell me who's trying to do what, how you're trying to help them with advantage, if you were trying to help them with advantage. Okay. Once I tell you roll a dice, that's it. So I'm going to try using that as a DM, and I'm trying to get away from the, oh, I failed, so let's just roll another until I pass, right? Because that kind of defeats the purpose of even rolling.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So it's something that I'm trying to do as a DM. This is the best way for me to put that. Okay?
Okay.
All right. I'm learning.
Okay.
I'm learning. I'm learning as a DM. I'm growing as a DM.
All right, well, let's rest through the night, and then we'll make our way in the morning.
Wait, he said he would tell us something else. Was that it, or...?
No. So that's what I was wanting to tell you. With that, it sounded like RJ is trying to see what's around, at least. Which I'm perfectly okay with. Is that what... are we doing that?
Yeah, I guess if I was going to do just busy work while we're here, I'd probably want to search over in this area and look for alchemy plants and sticks I can make arrows, that kind of shit.
Okay. So anybody
coming with me to do that? Because, I mean, there's not much here to see where we could go, so.
If no one else will, I'll
go with you.
So you're wanting to go outside at night?
It's only six right now.
It's only six right now, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I'll go with you in the evening.
I'll go with you too then.
Alright. So I've got an RJ, I've got a Dev, and I got a Cappy.
Yep.
Does that sound about right?
Mm-hmm.
No. Kane, you're not marked, are you?
No, I'm not.
Mm-mm. Okay.
Just you and me that I know of.
And Wiz.
Yeah, and Wiz.
Wiz and Irina, actually.
Oh, yeah, Irina,
as far as player, as far as player characters go. So, literally, it's the four of you. It's Dev, Wiz, Cappy, and then Irina.
Okay.
All right, so, with that, because all three of you are technically leaving, go ahead and give me a perception check from all three of you, please. Tommy's gonna see it. I didn't need one from you, X. I haven't heard it. Are you going with them?
Oh, no, sorry.
Okay. All right.
You can ignore that.
No, you're fine. Semi-L, he's excited about rolling dice, man. I get it. Semi-L and Kami. You guys actually see it. Kinda from the distance, not super far away. Let me open this here. Activate this scene. Come on. Not super far away from the bone grinder, but as you're kind of looking around, you will see four pillars standing around some kind of possible altar, something there. Not really making a whole lot of sense, but there's definitely man-made construction, or maybe not man-made, but non-natural bearing construction of some sort. Not super far away from the bone grinder or from the bone grinder mill, but a little bit away. That is actually going to be towards the, I think that's towards the east on the map. So while you were looking to go west into the forest, this is kind of towards your east.
Oh, I didn't see it. So
no, it's not on the map. It's not on the map at all.
Well, no, I'm saying my perception check. Okay, I didn't see it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
No, you were focused on the forest boss. So, it's up to you guys what you guys want to do with that. I'm just giving you the option.
Do you guys see that thing out there?
See something.
It looks like four dicks coming out of the ground.
Yeah, something like that.
You see that, Kane?
No. Where's
he
it?
He does now. If you point it out, I'm sure he can
point it out to him now.
Yeah.
Oh.
See that? It's like, it's not trees. It's like four rock dicks just shooting out of the ground. There's something in the middle.
Yeah, it definitely looks man-made. Did you guys want to check that out really quick?
I mean, if you want to. Well, we can check it out in the morning.
So, we see the lake too, right? From where we're at?
No, you do not. It's a little far away still.
They told us though the direction. Oh no, that was just they said down the path further.
Yep, go
is
down
this
the path.
Down the path, or is this off the path?
This is off the path. There's no actual path going to this. You're kind of like in. I don't want to call it a prairie because it's just like old and weeds, but like you're kind of in a prairie of old of just old rocks and weeds.
Well, that's interesting. Maybe we check it out later, like after we get these marks taken off, we can go check that out. But I'm hesitant to go anywhere outside of where we need to go right now.
Okay. I'm fine with that. We'll continue on to the forest for now, I guess.
All right, so you guys are headed off into the forest. I'm not going to bring up a map for any of that. Here's what we're going to do. What are each of you guys actually trying to look for or do?
I am literally surveillance, just trying to keep an eye out for anything that would attack us.
And I'm going
to
help him.
That's what he needs to do.
I'm helping him.
Okay. Kane, sounded like you were looking to gather herbs. Some herbs and spices and maybe some ammo. What would you look
for?
Yep. Very well then. So from you, let's get a nature check from you, and then let's get a perception check from Dev and Cappy, please. Okay. All right. Samael, you're kind of walking around, and Kami, you're able to keep a lookout, but man, you're real concerned about what's going on in your forehead right now. Like this land has just been fucking with you, man. All of a sudden now you're thirsting for blood, and you know, now you've got this damn mark on your head that makes you feel exhausted and fucking trying to get some a good night's sleep. And no, hell no, they're not gonna let you get a good night's sleep here. This place sucks. Right, Samael. You're actually, with that 23, you see a couple of wolves, but you're able to probably, unless you specifically tell me that you want to go towards them, you're able to kind of veer the party away from any points of danger, right?
Good.
That's what you're looking for. All right, so that's what you're going to do. Kane, while you don't find a whole lot out here, right, this is just kind of a... It's a lot of weeds, a lot of things like that. You do, all right? You're headed into a forest. I'm sure you could probably find some straighter sticks that you may be able to do some stuff with, right? So it's not the, you know, it's not useless coming out here, right? You do get some stuff. Go ahead and roll me a D10, please.
10.
All right. If you take the time and you you make the effort during this rest that is not a rest, you can go ahead and add 10 arrows into your inventory.
Thank you.
Okay.
All right.
So, other than that, you're not you're not finding any specialized plans for potions or any of that stuff, right? So, while they're off doing that, Arashi X, what do you guys do? You muted if you're talking to Rashi.
Thank you. X, you can go first if you want. Or Wiz.
Okay. Like I said, I was just looking to see if there was anything in the entire mill that had, there was a book or a scroll that had any arcane sigils.
What languages do you speak?
I believe it's Common and Draconic? Well, okay. Let me tell you for sure.
Yep.
Common, Draconic, Orc. Yep.
Okay. So as you're kind of moving around, you see some, we'll call them runes. You don't understand exactly what is written on here, but specifically the windmill, while it's just locked in place and kind of going back and forth, and it's not really necessarily doing a whole hell of a lot, you do see where it was normally meant to come down and grind something, right? And given the residue that's on there, right, you can see that this is probably some bone. There's definitely some blood, right? They were probably organic matter, right? And there's these weird runes that are kind of written and etched into these things, and you know, you're able to pick a little bit of bone powder out to get a better image of what some of them that are actually on the top where it was actually grinding. It almost seems like someone was using this as kind of like a magical grinder is the best way for me to put this, but unfortunately you're unable to make out what that language is, right?
Okay.
But other than that, the hags aren't really known to leave, you know, magical notebooks or any of that stuff.
Okay. I'm gonna... Do I have some paper? Nope, never mind.
All right.
Is there any paper and like a piece of charcoal around here?
Trying to take kind of like an etch or something like that of
yeah.
What's written.
Or like
there.
You know, if I can, you know, I'll sit there and like etch them out, you know, hopefully in order.
Okay. You can just put a little note somewhere or something like that. Just call it bone grinder etch, right? And okay. you'll know what that's for. Just put that in your notes or put that on your D&D page as an item, and we can get back to that for sure.
All right.
Okay. All right. With that, if nobody else necessarily wants to do a whole hell of a lot, obviously you've already taken your long rest, so you guys are kind of, you know, maybe polishing your armor, sharpening your swords, right? Just doing the kind of preparation, knowing you're probably walking into something, right? The last but not least, you know, you're going to have Irina, right? She starts to doze off and she wakes herself up kind of screaming, right? Kind of makes it a little unnerving, to say the least, for the rest of you, right? If she's already this bad, like, you guys had some bad dreams, right? But if it's getting worse, what's that in store for you guys? What does that leave for you? What time would you guys like to leave?
What time is the sun up?
The sun doesn't really necessarily rise in Barovia.
Okay, well, yeah. Right? What time does the day start?
Daylight, right? We'll say maybe around like 6:30 is the first sign of actual light, give or take.
Uh-huh. Did y'all want to leave around then?
Yeah.
Okay.
First thing in the morning.
That's fine.
Sounds good. Yeah.
Very well then. I will move you guys over. Dev, you know how this kind of works, right? You're the controlling factor for this. Let me know if you're staying on the path, if you're trying to
cross
the path.
Yeah,
we're staying on the road. Yeah, staying on the road.
Yeah, we're staying on the road.
All right. So somebody, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Ten, 11, 14, and
can
right
we
about
see the,
here
we should
is
be able to see the water now, right?
Yes, yes. In fact, actually, you see, and I was just about to say that, from right here, you guys have got 14, so using the handy-dandy travels for details, right? For you, each kilometer is 10 minutes for a healthy person, right? So you're about 140 minutes in. So that's 2 hours. Okay. That's about 8:30, about 8:40 in the morning. Okay. I'm going to do my best to try to start keeping track of that stuff for you guys. Okay. So
I'm writing it down too.
Yep. So we're going to say 8:40. AM is current time.
I will be right back.
Now, you guys, being able to kind of look down, you're going to see an actual... a path leading down towards the lake. Right. This seems to be a very... It's not a buggy kind of path, but it is a well-traveled path where, you know, this could very easily be the path that you guys need to take to get to Lake Zurich.
Okay.
Oh, fisherman's path. Best way for me to put that. Is that where you guys are planning on headed?
Yep.
Yeah, we're looking for the guys, so.
Okay, alright.
We don't see any structures at all, though, yet, right?
Well, I am about to do this for your viewing benefit. Your viewing pleasure! I worked on a few things. Come on, load in. It really likes that 98%. There we go.
Yeah.
Your viewing pleasure, ladies and gentlemen. So you can kind of see up on the hill there, there's a town up farther. But from where you guys are headed down, here's Lake Zurich.
Yes, I didn't miss it. Oh. I fucking love these. What a great DM.
I'm not good at describing things, but I am good at showing you what you need to see.
Yeah.
So you guys got the lake, you know, you guys do have some old docks, some ships that may not be in the best best condition, but maybe, you know, transversible. There is a small house or bait shop or, you know, some kind of structure. You do have the lake itself.
Something tells me I don't want to go in that.
Why not?
Looks like fun.
Have your docks to a couple of boats in the water at least. All right, welcome to Lake Zurich. All right, with that, you guys are all headed actually in, here's what I'm going to do. First off, configuration. All right. I need to know kind of what order you guys are actually deciding to walk in. How you guys are actually doing this.
I'd probably be further back.
All right. Best way, I think the best way for me to do this, I'm just going to put you on the map. All right. Do not go crazy on me for just a minute. All right. Basically, where Arashi is, headed backwards, you can kind of see the path right here, right? That you guys were using to take down. I do, in fact, need a couple of things from you. I'm guessing that you took Irina with you.
Yeah.
Who's walking along. What I need from you guys is to put yourselves in kind of the walking order, right? Or the marching order that you guys would like. And then I need perception checks from all of you.
Okay.
So we're headed to the west on this map, correct?
You guys are, in fact, headed to the west, yes.
Okay.
Wait, can I roll my IRL die and then tell you what I get?
You can. I'll allow it, only because it's your birthday die.
Thank you!
If you start getting a bunch of high rolls, we're going to have a conversation.
I wouldn't lie. I got a 10. I'm not going to lie to you. I'd never do that. Thank you for trusting me.
Yeah. Yeah, just a 10. Perception, just a plus 0. So, yep, just straight 10.
Nice.
Okay. Kami.
Reception.
It's you, buddy. So, Samael, you see something kind of moving around in these weeds a little bit, right? Kami, you smell it, bro. All right. Nat 20 from X here. All right. Never mind. All right. Kami, you smell this thing, and it kind of gets your attention a little bit. But X, you see it. You're actually the first one to see it. Given that, you know, you've been attacked by moving bushes and trees, man, you don't trust nothing. Nothing. So as you're actually looking at this thing, you start to see it. You see a set of eyes. Kind of just, it's in the weeds. You see a quick set of eyes just open and close. They're large, but they're in the water, and they're watching you.
Okay, I'm going to point it out to everyone. It's like, we got eyes in the weeds, and they ain't small.
DM, what does it smell like?
So,
like fishy?
It is a little fishy, and given X's Nat 20, I'm going to give you a sound as well. You hear a croak.
A croak?
Yes.
Frog.
Giant frogs.
Is that a big ass frog?
As it'll recede into the water ever so much, you'll see not just a few of these weeds move out of the way, but a large portion. Almost like if three of you had jumped into the water and moved these weeds out of your way. When we say big, we mean big.
I'm going to look at Arashi and be like, should I ribbit at it?
I'll do it with you. Want me to?
All right, on three. One, two, three.
Ribbit.
Anything happen?
I think it did it back. Did it?
It did not.
Oh. Should we do it louder?
Yeah, let's go a little louder.
Okay.
One, two, three.
Ribbit, motherfucker!
Oh.
Cappy, I love you.
Ribbit, motherfucker!
Anything?
You'll see it move towards you.
Okay, I think that worked.
Both Kami and Arashi, you hear something in your head. Come. Come closer.
Oh.
You don't hear that?
Yeah, I ain't hearing shit.
I didn't hear anything.
Come closer.
Okay, so Kami heard that too. Yeah.
The water's
okay, you
nice.
Heard the same thing?
Yeah.
The water's...
Water's... I'm like, fuck you, I hate water.
I'm a step forward.
That hell sounds no. like a bad idea.
Hello.
I'm not doing it.
Tell me why. You'll
see it. You'll see the weeds. You'll see the weeds right about there start to kind of part.
Show yourself.
We're friendly.
You sure that's a good idea?
Join me. The water's
you join
nice.
Us.
The water. If you think you're so good.
Jump right. on out. The air is fine.
It's telling us to come into the water with it.
We mean you no harm. Come out.
I don't want to go in the water, guys.
I can't go in the water.
It's just sitting there eyeing you. One, like, couple of large eyes. As the water starts to recede a little bit, you see the top portion of a head. Reddish in color.
Like a toad head or like a human head?
Toadish. Lizardish for sure.
Just the top of its head?
Just the top.
What was the thing's name that we needed to get this tooth from?
Oh shit. Did they give it?
They did give it.
They did in fact give it. Mm.
I don't remember it though.
Oh no! Gitrog.
It is the Gitrog.
Gitrog. Is that you?
Scared. Stay away.
What did he say?
Stay away. Is that what you said? Is that what he said?
Scared, stay away.
He's scared, stay away.
But you just told me to come closer.
Gitrog. Gitrog, scared. Stay away.
Okay, you're Gitrog.
No. Stay away from Gitrog.
Who's Gitrog?
Gitrog eat.
Gitrog eat?
Is it Kutz? Kutz? Is that the other one?
What's your name?
This thing is not intelligent at all. So, like you're getting that through. But it has some ability to be able to speak in your mind.
Okay. Where Gitrog?
You who?
You're gonna see it.
Where Gitrog?
You're gonna see it start moving forward.
I'm gonna back up.
Eat.
Hungry?
He says he's hungry, guys. I'm assuming that means us, which I'm not down for, but.
Yo.
I can't determine if this is the thing we need or not.
I'm gonna see.
I'm gonna walk up here and set a ration on the ground and yep. then back up again.
Same thing, let's go.
Backing a little further away. From the ration.
I'll go right here.
I'll stay right there then.
Brother,
hey, yo, X, what you doing, buddy? Come on, in the water.
I'm staying away, trust me.
Brothers. I call brothers. Brothers.
Oh, shit.
All brothers?
Your brothers?
Is Gitrog your brother?
I can be your brother.
Tommy, what?
I don't know. I'm just trying to figure this thing out.
I mean, he doesn't sound like the most intelligent thing, you know. So I don't know if he even understands that. Yes, we're brothers. I don't like the mouse movement, DM.
Placing that, he didn't come up try to eat nothing. No.
He's not coming up to try to eat anything.
Let's just kind of circle around this.
I'm down. Y'all can go first.
Brothers. I eat before brothers. I eat.
Not the game paw. Oh my, that thing huge.
It's not small at all. And frankly, those teeth are meant to rip, shred, and tear. It's hungry. And it's got six people standing in front of it. And it wants to eat before its brothers.
Yeah, okay.
It is not getting an extra turn. Now. Oh, it's coming out and it's moving towards you aggressively to the point where we are rolling for initiative.
As it's charging out, can I see if it has a necklace on with a tooth hanging from it?
But he said he's not.
It does not.
Yeah. Okay.
It does not.
This isn't what we want. We
not robbed. Again. Hold are on you a serious?
Second. Hold on a second.
He just nat 20 his initiative.
I know he did. I gotta add you guys to this initiative. Stop it.
I do what I want.
That's a good nat 20. Bro, no. Not even. I got a 2.
Crap. I'll roll your stuff. You got a 2. All right.
I'm gonna cry.
Will you take my 20 or do I gotta roll again?
I will take your 20. I'll put it in manually.
Okay.
Red slot.
This thing.
If that's a slot, we're screwed. That's metagame, out of character. X didn't say that.
We had a 20, we had an update 20. And then we had a gentleman who rolled a nat 20, so he's just going ahead of everybody. I'm just going to say...
I was expecting at best a 16. No, it's got to change my ideas completely.
Update. All right, so you have been... Oh! Did it really just rename you 24? What the hell? Hold on a second. I don't know why it's doing that. Just
so X is now 24, guys.
X is now 24. Alright. Arashi, you said you got a what?
2.
A whole 2.
Yep.
Alright. Arena. Not much of anything else. And worse than that, hey Wiz,
sir,
no metagaming.
I'll be honest with you, I don't remember much about them. Last time I ran one was second edition. I'm sure they've changed something between then and now.
All right, I'm going to unpause the game. As X, you see this thing rise out of the water, just slime coming, like dripping off of it, almost out of its pores. You see a long tongue, rather large teeth and lips.
You an ugly son of a bitch.
He is an ugly son of a bitch.
Okay, that being the case... And he definitely looks reptilian, right?
Oh, he looks reptilian for sure.
Okay. Just wanted to double check, because, you know, like if he if he had fur or something coming off covered by that slime, you know. Okay. I am going to cast Blur on myself.
Okay. Disadvantage on attack rolls against you.
Yep. And since I did that, do I have anything I can... no, that'll be it. Because I ain't hurting nobody else.
Very well. Okay.
Alright, so I pretty much know this thing's going to come aggressively towards us, right?
Oh, this thing, you can tell this thing's looking at you like your food.
Okay, I'm gonna cast Hunter's Mark on it. Whoops, right, wrong button. Didn't mean to roll it. And I'm going to use my longbow to take a shot. Guessing 10 doesn't hit.
10 unfortunately does not hit.
Okay. Back up a little bit, and that'll be it.
So be it. And with that, we move over to Semi-El. Semi-El.
I'm gonna cast Blessed on us. On, one, two. Oh, not her. Three and four.
As you hear in the back of your mind, oh, pretty froggy. Froggy. froggy meat. You hear the young kid yet again taunting you. Can't wait to see you die.
All right, so you four got a 1d4.
Who's all getting the four?
Everybody but Arena and me.
Everyone except for Arena and you. All right, so we got a bless.
Mm-hmm. And I'm going to step back to here. Yeah.
We have a bless. And last but not least, we have a bless. All right.
And that's my turn.
Seems movement very well. As you see this thing lumber out, it has come to meet the two of you. All right. Okay. First, I need to double check a few things here. All right. Well, Arashi, you're up first.
Mm-hmm.
As it looks at you. Gonna rip out with, as you look at these long paws, you see claws with like a good 4 inches of nail on the end of these things, and it's just going to reach out, tries to claw you, is unable to do so.
Mm-hmm.
Tommy, you get the secondary claw.
Damn.
I need a DC 14 con saving throw, please.
No.
Oh, no.
Very well. All right. And then last but not least, Arashi.
Mm-hmm.
Going to try to bite you.
Oh. Yep. Definitely. With that fucking crit, oh my god.
With that crit. That is 16 points of damage towards you. As it bites into you. That's your new health.
Oh, sorry, I did it on D&D Beyond. I forgot.
No, that's fine. I'm doing it inside of Foundry to keep track for myself, too.
Okay.
Alright. That is the end of its turn. Kami. This thing having slashed into you, just you feel the mark. Oh, that doesn't feel good.
Yeah. Okay. I'm gonna fucking die. Let's see.
It wanted food. It got a good old chunk of Arashi.
Yeah.
Well, I'm definitely gonna attack it. I'm just trying to cut away.
Do the thing! Or I'm gonna do the thing. I don't care what you do. I'm just kidding.
Doing thing, I just need to do the right thing.
Do the things.
Where the fuck is it? No. Sorry, I'm trying to find the right page. There it is.
Dr. Squism, or Dr. Squiggs says, do the thing, do the thing!
Okay.
Oh, what's up, Squiggs?
I am going to first attack it with my sword, my silvered sword.
Very well.
17 to hit.
17 hits.
For 18 damage with the sneak attack.
18 damage.
Nice.
Oh, God damn it. This thing's really starting to irritate me. I haven't been able to figure out why it keeps doing this. But, like, I type in minus 18, and instead of it actually taking off 18, it decides, like, whenever I hit a number key, it's deciding to use that as, okay, oh, 8? You mean you wanted it blessed? No!
Then...
I gotta do all this manually. All right, 18.
You should be able to target a click or select him, then right click on the damage or on the attack, like his damage, and hit apply damage.
Yeah, I'll start doing it that way. That might be easier.
Some of those work, some of them don't, depending on if they roll it inside like that your crit did. But if it's a separate roll, it should work.
So that problem is you guys are rolling from D&D Beyond. That's the problem. Like, if I made you guys, if I forced you guys to roll everything in Foundry, this would be a very much so quicker thing for me. But, you got your attack. You got your 18. Okay.
Hitting him with my Katarina.
24
to hit.
24 definitely hits.
For another 5 damage.
Another 5 damage. Got it. 5 it is.
And then I am going to try to bite him.
Very well. Try to bite him back.
Open my second point. That makes
perfect. 8 to
hit. Yeah, you're not biting.
Even with blessed?
You guys don't know the DC, so you can roll your blessed to find out. 9 does not.
9?
9 does not.
Why?
All right, that's it for me then.
All right.
Oh, before my turn ends, did the silvered sword appear to do anything more to it, or just like did what I expected a normal sword to do?
Did what you thought that it would do.
Okay.
All right. As this thing is looking around. Arashi, being the only one to have talked to Irina, trying to talk her down, right now she's afraid, and she's kind of backing up. What would you like Irina to do? She can continue to back up, maybe shoot off a crossbow, or she could try to join you and take a head off of this thing. What would you like?
I would... slightly turn. I'm not doing like a whole 180. I'm still keeping my eyes on this thing. Just like look over my shoulder and then say, Irina, it's okay if you're scared. If you want, you can use your crossbow. You don't have to fight this thing like head on yet.
They say less. She will, she will back up. She will fire off her crossbow.
I love you.
She will miss with an 11. She's gonna use her bonus action to reload, cock it back. Real shaky. She's gonna let off another one. And with a 12, she will miss as well.
It's okay, just breathe. Alright.
And that brings us to you, Arashi.
So, you know, something I always forget, I won't forget Divine Smiting this shit if I hit. Just saying. Just saying. So, and then I'm gonna swing with my longsword. I'm just gonna do this one because it's complicated on D&D Beyond.
Well, what's
your name? Oh, D4. Please. Please. Where is it? Oh no.
A 12 will miss.
Fuck. I'm just gonna look at Kami and say, I think my arm's a little tired.
It's nice to see our roles carried over to fucking 2023. Fuck, man.
For real, bro, I can't.
Alright, if that is your turn, we move over to X.
Alright.
Is X gonna give it to you? Let's find out.
Yep.
Yes, I'm an old man. I make old man jokes.
I am going to cast Magic Missile at second level.
Alright. See what you got.
So, looks like 5 points of damage.
That's the first one. Roll me a couple more d4s, please.
Alright. Oh, so that'd be,
I need one more d4.
One more? Okay.
You did it at, you said at second level, right?
Yeah.
That's four fours. Alright, so that is plus another 3, 7, 10. That is 15 points of damage. That's 15.
And, let's see. Yeah, that's like 15 feet, right? Oh, 20. Oh, 15 feet, yeah. I'm going to use my, my psionic mind ability, and I'm going to send it a message saying, "You're gonna lose," and that's all I'm gonna say.
You're gonna lose.
Yep. Psychological warfare.
You just get a thing back in your mind that just says, "Food." All right, Kane.
All right.
Take a duel.
Taking my shot. 21 hit.
21 hits. Really good damage. Colossus and Slayer, so that's 15. Add your... plus an additional one. You know what? That's perfectly fine. As this arrow pierces in, you just see a green ooze come out as this thing is officially bleeding.
That's it for me.
Very well. Semi-al.
Gonna step up right here. Touch Kami on the shoulder. Give him some healing. Then I'm just gonna probably step back just in case. And then I could do a cantrip still, right?
Yes, I allow for you. Well, Cure Wounds was an action. So unless you have a bonus action cantrip.
Okay, then no. That's it.
Okay. All right. Well, Arashi.
Mm-hmm.
Do you want the good news or you want the bad news?
Just hit me with both.
The good news is that you have the most AC out of everybody.
Yep.
The bad news is that he seems focused on you.
Yep. Which is fine by me. This is not calling.
I mean, yeah. From my perspective, that's definitely the way it should be.
But if I not do it again...
Jesus Christ, Tony.
Okay.
I can't.
DC 14? But I fell, DC. Too. Oh
my God. Okay. Okay.
Actually, wait, that was a 12, but I still failed.
Good bless.
Oh.
You do have bless.
Where's my D4? Fuck it. I'm just going to roll it on because I can't find it.
Just don't roll the one. She rolls a one! Jeez! Alright. Okay, alright. Orange. Oh,
so I take 14 damage.
Okay. Well, first of all, something that you will notice.
Uh-huh. Awesome. Oh, my D4 now.
As it is its turn, I put it in chat so that you guys can see this.
Okay.
You see the wound, you see the arrow push out, and as it pushes out, you notice the bleeding has stopped. Now, it does hit you. Unfortunately for you, that is 19 points of damage.
Because it did 19? Right. Oh my god. Okay, I did 14, we do 5, 4.
I got you. So that is...
Damn!
Yep. You notice that it no longer is paying attention. And it will walk over, like, it moves kind of not necessarily around you, but over you. And it finds X. This is a disadvantage, I know.
Yep.
But you just so happen to be the next person in the line, boss.
Gee, thanks, asshole.
Give me a second. I'm rolling with disadvantage. Nice. A nat 1. All right. So, did you guys see my new nat 1 table?
No.
All right. I invite everybody, since this is the first new nat 1 of 2020, I have actually written things down so that you guys know now what is more important or what is actually for the nat 1s. If you nat 1, you roll 2d10s. So, rolling 2d10s. That is a 15. On a 15... out of position for footwork. Disadvantage on all attack rolls and strength dex saving throws until the end of the next turn. That is his nat 1. So with disadvantage, it's going, as it misses you, it's going to try to chomp at you. Granted, he already had disadvantage, but it's still trying to do it at disadvantage. I know a 9 does not, but let's see if you get a nat 1 on the other. It does not. So,
oh, a plus.
9 misses, correct, X?
Yep.
All right, that'll be the end of its turn. Tommy, you see this thing standing over. Having hit you and having hit Arashi, is now not interested in you, which seems a little weird.
Fucker. I'm the tastiest one here. And I'm gonna fucking hit him with the short sword.
Alright, go for it.
20 to hit.
20 most definitely hits.
Or 18 with sneak attack.
18 points of damage. It will take that 18.
Second attack. 23 to hit.
23 definitely hits.
Or...
I don't think it's 23, but I think it's 20, which still hits.
Oh, it's, 21.
Still hits. For another 7 points?
7. Yep.
Alright, this thing is bleeding profusely.
I'm gonna bite him.
Bite him back. Arr!
Get some, motherfucker.
Nat 20.
Nat 20. Alright.
Oh, yeah.
So, first few things on this. So, your initial damage is 6 plus another 4, so that is 10. Right off the bat. And then it needs to roll for
Constitution saving. Yep.
Constitution coming in. Constitution saving throw. 18.
Okay.
So does it take the necrotic?
If it saves, yeah, it won't take the necrotic.
Okay.
That's still fat
it piercing damage.
It did take some fat piercing damage. Is there you can move if you still want to move?
No. I'm gonna just be chomping on his fucking leg.
Very well. And with a couple of heavy crossbow bolts at this thing, we'll hit only needed 4 points of damage. That's all that he had left. After that
nice.
Massive 20. With Kami chomping into the neck of this thing. You
What's
just
going,
feel it
you know?
Push back as the heavy crossbow comes in. Hitting it square between the eyes, you feel the thing go limp. With that, you are out of combat.
Yay.
Hot dog.
One second here. I just need to look at some stuff.
I want to break its teeth off.
Oh no. I'll hand you a dagger and say, here, cut him out. I want one.
Okay.
I just had to look at some stuff. I apologize.
Oh, good.
I need to just see how certain things were written, for sure. All right, so you guys are cutting teeth out. All right, might as well give me a nature check. See how good of a job you guys do.
Survival? You're cutting things up?
Okay, I'll take it.
Does he count as a child?
It counts as a slot is what it counts as. 18. 18, saying, you're able to get a couple good-sized teeth out of there for sure.
Do you want this thing turning into a fucking bird? A giant flying toad bird?
Listen, at least I don't feel bad. It doesn't go against my morals. Kill
it. I'd rather give it him a fucking child than give him this fucking behemoth.
And then that thing go and attack people? Yeah, I agree. As I hand Wheeze some undead. I hand Wheeze two of the teeth.
Cool.
Can I check it to see if any parts of it are useful for alchemy?
Roll me an investigation check.
Ten.
Not that you could tell.
Okay.
All right. As Arashi, you're feeling tore up from the floor up, is the best way for me to put it.
Mm-hmm.
If there is only a paladin way for her to be able to heal herself.
No, but that's the thing. I have something. I was just waiting.
Okay. You do your thing.
I'm gonna use my potion of greater healing because I know he has brothers, he said. So we're probably gonna be fighting. So hold on. +4 I get 15 back.
15?
Yeah.
And you're doing it. Got it. Perfect.
That's a good starter. Hold on, let me make sure I remove it so I don't think I have another one. And then I'm gonna do lay on hands.
Okay.
I'm gonna do lay on hands for like 5. Yeah.
Tell me how you looking.
Give me 1 second.
For another 5, you said?
Yeah, I'm at like 29 out of 44.
You're fine. It'll be fine.
You have 44 HP?
Yeah.
Remember, you guys
must be fucking nice.
Remember, you guys got 5 subtracted from your top HP.
Yeah, I know. I have 22 HP.
Yeah,
she's a paladin, bro.
I did the feat too, so I got double HP.
Life.
I was like, the way that we're getting into fights, we need a tank. And I was like, I'll do it. Okay.
Right. Happy.
You're with my 20 fucking HP. I'm fine. I'm only missing one.
All right.
Hey, good.
As this goes on, I need everybody to roll me. Or what's everybody's passive?
17.
17.
Oh, no, sorry. No, it's 14. 15 for perception.
13.
15 is the highest
perception
passive?
Is the 15, yeah.
I thought someone said 17. Oh.
No, mine's an insight.
Oh.
Semi-L, you hear movement out of the bushes. As you turn around to look, you see 2 more of these creatures emerging from behind you.
Behind me?
Behind you.
Like here?
Yes, in that general direction.
Fuck. I'm going to like, hey guys, there's 2 more coming behind us. If we want to go, we better go.
Yeah, let's move.
Where are
you
staying
fight? As you will see, Arena just be like, almost jumping into the arms of Arashi at this point. Like,
oh, Okay.
I say we head towards the shack.
Sounds good.
Yeah.
Is it this way?
It's towards the left. So I'm not gonna make you guys actually move over in that general direction.
Yeah, we're headed to the
beating building. Feet to get the fuck out of there.
Alright, yeah. give me one quick second here. I gotta find him. He is here somewhere. He is right there. Got it. Okay. Alright. So let's move you guys over. You guys have decided to pass right past the docks and whatnot. You guys continue to keep running and whatnot. As you see this, as you guys are running past everything, you'll see a gentleman standing on the dock in front of the house, climbing into a boat and pushing off.
I'm gonna yell at him to get inside.
There is shit coming.
He doesn't seem to pay much attention. And with that, Arashi, Kane, Kami, Samael, X, and Arena. Your bless still going on. How long does bless last for? A minute?
I think so, yeah.
Probably only been about 30 seconds from this point. So from where you stand right now, the dock would be, or the docks would be over to your right. The house is here on your left.
Okay.
And he literally just pushed off and started moving towards the north.
Okay.
Is there another boat around?
Down the docks.
Back here.
Yes.
Yeah, I want to go.
If you ran down the dock, if y'all ran down the docks, you could get onto a boat if you wanted to.
Is that the guy we need?
I don't know yet.
Right, we don't know yet, though.
Also, do we want to get on a boat and go into the water with lizard thingies that look like they're good in the water and can fuck us over?
We could just wait them out at the cabin.
That's what I'm thinking.
Okay, let's run to the cabin.
Sounds good to me.
Let's go. Wait, hold on. Irina, come on.
Irina's coming. She'll come. She'll walk along with you.
Eat, motherfucker.
And by walking along, I figure y'all are probably running at this point because those things are on your ass.
Oh, wait. Is the door right here?
The door's on the other. Yeah, the door's on the other side.
Let's go, guys.
So
let's
as
go.
As you guys are running, you turn to look behind you. And there's another one just barreling down. Like, almost on all fours.
Open door.
Chasing after your ass.
Inside.
Oh, wait. I think we both clicked on it at the same time and I closed it.
Everybody in?
That was the door.
You closed the door on us. Stop closing the door. Stop closing the door, damn it.
Everybody in? Get it.
I'm going to bar the door behind us.
How is the door operated? Like, is it just like a pull door? Is it actually a knob? Like, what's the door look like?
Hold on a second.
We got a bar on the inside.
Can you guys see on the inside?
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Audience cannot see on the inside. Somebody step outside for me for just a second.
No, not all of us. Outside, okay, go back.
Outside, like actually, go further. Uh-oh. Go further. All right, now go back in.
Okay, go back in. Okay, great.
I'm wondering why
you need to give the audience the ability to, an owner, not just an observer. I think
audience has it for observer for all of them, but I'll do it as an owner for at least one of you guys. There we go. All right, that's better. So you guys have all come barreling in here, right? As you come in, give me a just with the passive as you're barreling in, it's the smell that hits you first of all things. You come in, fish, like dead rotting fish. You take a look around. This place is fucking nasty, like. Cutting or cut fish, cut different portions of fish, just rotting in the corner. The bed itself looks like it probably hasn't been cleaned in, you know, 6 to 8 months, right? Like, if not longer. There's you know, there's writing on the wall. Right? It looks like this place, if you hadn't just seen someone, like, leave this place, you would think that this place was not just abandoned, but, like, you know, the village kids had been coming down here to trash it.
Well,
good housekeeping, I see. What's the door like? Does the door have, like, a latch? Does it have anything to keep it closed?
It does not, but as you look out, there are some windows, right? As you look out of these windows, you notice the slots leave. That they have stopped chasing you.
Wait, I want to go back outside.
Go.
That's fine, I'll do it. I ain't scared. I'm scared. I'm not scared.
I'm scared. I'm
don't worry, we'll come with you. Let me close the door behind me. There you go.
Walking around, you're looking around. As far as you can see, you look out into the middle of the lake, and there's just one guy just sitting on a boat, fishing.
Just fishing?
Just fishing.
Bold move, Cotton.
Doesn't seem like he has a care in the world.
So, talking to the group, like, the witches or hags or whatever the fuck they are, they asked us to get a tooth from this guy.
Mm-hmm. So,
assuming if they want to fuck with this guy, he's probably not a bad person, even given the state of his place.
Well, we should probably wait outside. So, I didn't try to think we're stealing shit other than we ran in there, you know.
But I'm just saying, like, maybe we try not to... We don't
attack him and kill him? First option. Yeah. Yeah. You know, that sounds like a great idea.
Do you think we should all stay out here, or should we wait inside?
I think we should stay outside, because it smells like shit in there.
It smells like shit everywhere here.
Yeah, well, know, it's less shitty. Be in here, or come out for some fresh air? Okay, great answer, Queen.
She's taking it out. She's like, all right. Fuck this.
Before I leave, if I'm just glancing around really quick, do I see anything that looks like a tooth necklace sitting anywhere?
Give me an investigation check.
Nice.
You do not find a tooth. However, you do find a book with some writing in it. Maybe a journal of sorts.
Is it in a language I understand?
It's
like
a common
or something?
It's a common.
Common. Nothing written on the cover, I'm guessing?
Nope, but you can tell it's probably a journal.
Gonna open it to a random page. See what it says.
Roll me a d20.
Okay, look 17. At
you. You did fairly well. So, for whatever reason, something tells you maybe go towards the back, right? Like, the front stuff is normally probably pretty boring, but the back stuff may actually be something. And you see a thing about, I finally caught it. It broke away, but it broke a tooth. The sheer size of it. It's every fisherman's dream. I finally have proof that the Githrog exists.
Write that down.
Githrog exists. Does it say anything about where he found it? In that journal?
He said he finally caught it, so I'm assuming he's fishing.
I said it got away.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I mean, where on the water he found it? Huh? Maybe we can get some fishing gear and fish for it ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, can you spell that for me?
Spell what?
The name of the fish or whatever the fuck he caught.
You asked me this same thing last time. I literally heard you ask for that. You asked for that like 7 times today because I rewatched the vid and I made sure that I got the name right.
Okay, if I got it already, then okay, I got you.
You got it.
Thank
it's
you.
It's the Gitrog. GITROG.
Oh, Gitrog. I thought you said get the rock. I don't know why.
And that's the same shit that you said last time. She's pretty good.
All right, if I flip it over to the next page or whatever, you know, just kind of scanning through this, does it have any type of location for this thing?
Say that one more time, boss.
I said, continuing reading, like flipping the page over.
Oh, yeah, there's more stuff. There's more stuff. So you keep reading?
Yeah.
So you start to, you see another page talking about just dreams. Keep flipping, not feeling right. And as you kind of keep going, there's only about 3 or 4 more pages, but as you kind of keep going, the writing starts getting sloppier and sloppier until it's unlegible.
Okay. But he doesn't talk about where this thing was.
As you kind of keep, as you start looking around, you'll see the Gitrog keeps the slods away. Weathering its tooth gives me protections.
All right, I'm going to put the journal back where I found it, as it was. And then I'm going to head outside with the others and let them know what I just read. Yeah, so apparently that tooth keeps the slods away. They're afraid of the Gitrog. Couldn't find any info on where it might be, only that this guy sure it exists, he's seen it, and he got a tooth from it.
And that's the tooth we need.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Gonna go on the boat?
Not really. I don't. You gotta get on a boat. I don't do water.
I'll get on a boat, but I mean,
I deal with rotting fish before I deal with the open water.
And go back inside. I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. Okay.
Have fun. Bye. See you in the next life.
What life?
Yeah, me. I'll stay with Cappy.
No, we don't actually have to get in the boat. I was joking, but I mean, I will get in one if we have to.
I think we just wait till he comes back.
Yeah, that's all. That's why I said I was joking. But if we have to, I'll get in one. Yeah. So, the views, yeah.
So, as your DM, I'm trying not to give too much away. But as your DM, you wait an hour, the guy hasn't moved. You wait another hour, the guy hasn't moved.
Does anybody have, like, message or anything?
I do. But how far is he?
I mean, he's visible. It's probably a good, like, 400 or 500 feet away.
I can't. It's 120 feet, yeah.
Yeah, I can't. Oh, my ability
is
20 feet.
This is a big-ass lake. Like, when I say it's a big-ass lake, I mean it's a big-ass lake.
I'm going to use a cantrip, create light.
Oh.
And, like, make it, like, flicker. See if it catches his attention.
You will catch his attention.
Sweet. Does he come back?
He does not come back. But you do see him kind of stand and do this. As all of you are looking down at your cell phones.
All right.
Hey, Dadum.
I'll go get in a boat. Luke's coming with me.
I'll stay with Cappy.
Irina, you can stay with them if you want. You don't have to come.
I'll go with them.
Arena's gonna follow you, Arashi.
Okay. I don't know why she wants to follow me, but...
Because there's fucking red toads fucking slashing the shit out of people. You've got two people with marks on their forehead. One of them's got fucking fangs. Like...
All right, let's go, Irina. All
right, who all is going?
Me, everybody Kane, but... Irina, and X.
Everybody but me and Cappy.
Okay. This is going to get interesting real fast.
I'm so scared.
Mm-hmm. I'm scared for you. I'm not going to lie.
Uh-huh. I just say you're splitting the party.
You're splitting the party.
Yeah. I can't go in open water.
You can. You can be on a boat.
I will die.
You can get on a boat,
crossing
bro.
Crossing water gives me damage.
Not standing in water gives you damage. And not yet. And not yet.
I know, get in the fucking boat.
It's up to you if you guys want to get in the boat.
I'm sitting in the middle of the fucking boat and I'm not moving from the middle. Just sitting in it. Like, nope.
I am following Cappy.
Just right, closing my eyes the whole fucking ride.
Everyone heads out to the water.
He's getting in the middle of the boat. So, Samael and Arashi, I'm gonna let you two row the boat.
Okay.
All right, you guys get the row in the boat. I literally moved you guys to the jetty, and I am on the wrong thing on this one. Give me a second. I'm guessing
Kane is our eyes.
Sure. Kane, are you being the eyes?
Yeah.
Okay, so be it then. Hold on one second. What's up? I'm fixing my stream.
Six people in one boat. What could go wrong?
There's technically two boats. That's what I'm saying. But
oh, I thought he took the other one. Oh. Do y'all want to...
No, you can see on the map. You can see on the map that I'm showing you guys. There's technically two boats at the end of this.
Do y'all want to do three each or stay in one boat?
Let's take two, I'm thinking.
I'm down for two.
Okay.
Taking two boats?
I'll move over to the other boat.
I'm standing next to Cappy. All
right.
So I can heal him if he gets hurt.
I've got to prep that. Just give me 1 minute as you guys
trying to figure out. I wouldn't row. I would just be sitting. I guess I'd be the eyes.
Sitting in the middle.
All right, so Kane, you want to stay with me and Irina?
Yeah, whoever. We're doing three each, so.
Yeah, okay, cool. Okay.
X, are you, which boat are you in?
Number two.
Number two. All right, so you're going with, I'm going to have you row, and I'm going to have Samael row while Kami sits in the middle of the boat.
Shitting his pants.
All right. So you guys are able, fairly easily. You guys are moving along, just kind of rowing out there very slowly, very calmly. You notice the slods kind of get into the water, but they don't seem to leave the shoreline.
Okay.
We move over. You guys have taken two boats. You see a white-bearded individual kind of sitting out there. As you approach, I need perception checks from everyone, please.
Ooh, I got an 8.
9.
Yay.
4. 20.
Okay. At least Kane got a good one.
Samael.
Oh, and Samael.
You, as you kind of come up, you were in town long enough to kind of see the blank stares, right? The people who seem to be there without truly being there. You know what I mean?
Uh-huh.
Kane, you see this as well. But normally, you would think that as individuals were coming to row the boat, especially if someone had told you, come on, that it would be, you know, that they would be friendly, that they would say hello to you as you roll up. All you see is his pole in the water and him sitting there. Doesn't acknowledge your presence at all.
Do we know this guy's name? Who we're supposed to be getting the necklace from?
So, is he, Klutz?
We don't know who he is yet, because we haven't talked to him.
I don't know.
Oh, fair enough.
Just gonna kind of call out to him, hey, excuse me, sir.
You see him slowly turn his head.
Here to talk to you about your extended warranty.
I'm here to talk to you about your boat's extended warranty.
Is your name Klutz?
As he turns, you see his eyes, except they're white and hazy, as if he was dead. Just turns and looks. And in each of your minds, you all hear, you're here as dinner, or you brought something special?
Huh? Did y'all hear that?
Sir?
I don't serve anyone.
Myself.
As you say this, Samael, you feel something hit the bottom of your boat and the whole boat kind of rock.
This is fucking stupid. I told you motherfuckers. I told you motherfuckers. Should have just stayed back, Cappy.
As my children hungry.
Great.
We need
not him too.
A new servant to bring adventurers and townsfolk to the middle of the lake. Do you serve?
I'm gonna look at the dude. Does he have this tooth around his neck?
He definitely does.
Wait.
We can talk about this back at the hut.
Wait. Is Gitrog underneath us? Oh my god.
No, Gitrog is the bad guy. He's one of those worm thingies.
No, I know, but didn't he say that he found it and that's what he got the tooth from, right? And yep. He looks dead. So, like, what if Gitrog was, like, in the water? And that's why they don't go in the water.
They go in the water.
It's obvious. I think Gitrog's here.
No, I know, but no.
They definitely go in the water because the homeboy came out of the water to attack us last time.
No, I'm saying, but remember, they don't go in. They just stay in the shallow end. And that's why they don't go...
Because they're supposed to be bringing food to the big guy.
I know, I'm just saying, Gitrog is here somewhere, and I thought that's why the fisherman was here. But anyway, okay.
I think he is the servant of Gitrog.
Yeah. Moment, yeah.
And they're looking for a replacement because he's rotting, because he's dead.
Literally. Mm-hmm. That's why I'm saying the person talking to us must be Gitrog.
We can either row up to him real quick, take the tooth, and beat feet back. Or we're going to be dealing with some dumb shit.
I mean, we're already dealing with some dumb shit.
Let me see.
You serve.
If we were to serve... Oh. Your soul? Did he say, do you serve your soul?
No, he said, do you serve? And my answer was ourselves. What does serving entail, sir? Maybe I also want them to say that.
As just with your passives... You see a tentacle start climbing up the side of the boat.
Yep.
Okay. Let's go forward, grab the necklace, get the shit out of here.
Yep, he's in the water.
As soon as you start thinking this, you see this massive thing just right over the top of the boat, straight down on top. Crashing the boat in the center.
Okay. Guiding bolt.
Go ahead.
I got nothing else, boys.
Shoot away, my friend. If that's what you're doing.
Not yet. Yo. What if we serve? What do you want from us? I would ask you some questions. Y'all can start rowing if y'all want. We can start rowing back as I talk. But like, the tooth is gone.
So as you ask this question, before you start rowing back at top speed, fucking motorboating the shit out of the back of this thing, right? Right. He's already told you what he wants.
He wants adventurers.
He wants people out in the middle of the lake as a food source for his children. It seems everybody just wants people. Sound familiar?
Okay. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, what can you give us as a guarantee that you won't hurt us or that your children won't hurt us when we try to get you food?
I think we are the food.
No? He said he needs a new servant. He said he needs a new servant. I'm just trying.
He only needs one. He doesn't. There's two boats of three people apiece.
Okay. If I were to serve you, how could you protect me?
By eating your soul.
What did he say?
We keep the slods at bay.
Yeah. But how can you keep the slods at bay?
You just get images of like them moving towards the slot and the slot retreating in fear.
No, I know. I'm trying to get him to give me this fucking tooth. Like, I'm just trying.
I know what you're trying to do.
Oh my god. Okay.
So this creature out. Actually, like, I'm looking at this creature to see exactly what it is. You know what? I just read it. Orange.
Uh-huh.
I need to know what Arashi's greatest desire is.
Oh, vampire. Shit. It's vampires.
Her a kiss greatest from desire, Scrub. Like... Got it.
No, okay, like, so...
To take the place of Arena. Got it.
Shut the fuck up. So, what her greatest desire, like, in this moment or overall?
Just period. What is Arashi's greatest desire? Not the desire in the moment. The greatest desire of Arashi's entire life.
To rid the world of evil so everyone can have a safe place to live. Like, literally, like, you know, as a follower of Tyr, too. Like, that's, like, her main thing. Is to just vanquish as much evil as she can. That's, no evil.
You start seeing images of Arashi being hailed as a hero for taking out Strahd, for ridding Barovia of the werewolves. For everything, you start like almost like if all of your dreams were to come true, they just start appearing in front of you in random images. Join.
Okay, at this point, can I message to multiple people or no? Is it just one? Like, because I know it's one at a time, but I was wondering if in this scenario...
I think each individual message is a spell slot, so I'm just saying.
It's a cantrip for me. It's a cantrip.
Then I'll, since you're not in battle, I'll just allow it, like, over and over again.
Okay, cool. So I'm going to message to Kami first, all right? And Kami is going to hear Arashi say, "This thing is showing me what I want the most, but no... I am not going to feed you guys over. If you can, try and get away while I try to get this fucking tooth. And then she's gonna message to Kane. Fucking poor Irina. She's over here like, message to Kane.
She's scared shitless right now.
Yeah, that's why I don't want her saying shit out loud. I'm gonna message to Kane, saying the exact same thing for the most part. But because we're in the same boat, I'm gonna tell Kane, or Rasha's gonna tell Kane, swap places with me. If this tentacle looking thing tries anything, we gotta go. All right, so I'm just gonna step up, but I'm gonna try and get this tooth so we can go.
Hey, Kami. All right,
cool.
Yo,
bro, I know you're looking at the shoreline like, bro, I gotta fucking go, I gotta get the fuck out of here. Give me a perception check with advantage, bro.
Seventeen.
You're nice. Looking in the water. You're looking at this thing, right? You've heard the things again. The thing in front of you, kind of swimming around, isn't necessarily looking at you, but you still hear the messages in your head. It's like, what the fuck is going on, right? You look around. You see another large shadow moving around, and then you see another one. And then, as you look further down, you see a massive motherfucker. Like, when I say massive, I mean, like, how the fuck does it fit in Lake Zarevich? Fucking massive.
So, with message, I'm allowed to reply. I'm gonna reply back to Arashi and be like, we are getting fucking surrounded. The one in front of us is a fucking baby. We need to get the fuck out of here now.
Okay. Okay, I got you.
I was trying to play the DM thing of feed my babies to be like, hey guys.
Okay, so this is what's gonna happen then. Hearing this, Arashi will say, me and my friends would love to serve, but all of us must live so we can bring you more food. We will come back. I'm not laughing in character. I'm laughing because I'm just like, bro, I know I'm scared shitless and I'm not even in this boat. Anyway, we will come back with food for you and your children and brethren. Let's go, guys. Let's go.
I'm going to move you over. Just give me 1 minute. I know that there's two boats. Just give
me a
second.
Why is this thing
here.
Called Chase?
Just
why is this
give
thing
me a
called
moment
Chase?
Here. Because I knew you guys were going to fucking dip the fuck out. You thought I was crazy? You thought I was fucking crazy? I knew where you guys were fucking headed.
No, look, we don't think you're crazy. We already know that.
We know.
All right, so
crazy.
Now I right, see why they make me do the rower at the gym, guys. I'm ready.
This person's over here. And this person's right here. All right. So, here's what I need.
Fuck.
I need an initiative, please.
Okay. Where's my d20?
You know, okay, yep.
I got a 12.
You guys will both love this and hate this at the same time. Arashi, you said you got a 12?
Mm-hmm.
All right. As you guys are rowing, I'm going to give you a fresh turn yourself before counting in the initiative for the other. Here's a few options. This quote unquote boss battle is going to be a little different than what we've done previously. All right, we're gonna create some new things. You can choose to row as an action. You can move up to half your movement speed. Okay, in any direction that it is that you want. You can choose to take your regular actions. You can choose to cast spells. You can choose to cast whatever you want. I will not be screwing you guys over and having him dive underneath the water where you guys wouldn't be able to hit him, because that's just kind of fucked up. right? So I will not be pushing that portion of this action, okay? So you can choose to row. You can try to get to shore, right? I did tell you earlier, you're about 400 feet from the shore, so you're a good little while, right? But if you can stay ahead of them, right, try to do so. That's your choice, okay? Each individual person will be able to make their choice on their own. If you choose to move 15 foot in a single direction, you will be taking whoever is in the boat on the boat. So if you choose to move 15 feet in a direction that screws your party member, so be it.
I'm rowing.
Oh yeah, Kayla swap. I'll row. Oh, yeah.
Rowing.
Well,
or as, wait,
I,
is Irina?
I don't truly care where you guys actually are, right?
Oh, okay.
I'm just giving you the first round. You can prep, you can row, you can do whatever it is that you want. Just know that this thing is coming after you. Well, this baby is coming after you, at least.
I'm rowing.
Is Irina fit enough to row?
I'm pretty sure she's going to be like, get the fuck out. Bye.
No, yeah. I know, but what I mean mentally, since she's already been out of it.
Why would you ask such a question?
What? I mean, I was asking. I was hoping he'd give an answer. What the fuck? Yo, Kane, I think me and you should swap because you're the one that has the long range in case we ever do need to fight something. Is that cool with you?
I mean, all three of you can row if you really want to. Like, I'm not going to make you actually do that.
Oh, yeah, you said you don't fucking care. Yeah, I forgot. Okay.
Not for that.
Yeah. All right. Let's book it, guys.
I'm guessing our boat's getting the fuck out. Yeah, we're all on the same page in this boat. We're GTFOing.
Yep. Diddy Mo.
The one thing that I will say... is even babies have teeth.
Uh-huh.
Oh.
Yeah, well, we'll get one eventually.
Eventually. He's going to go back, long rest, lose 5 more health.
Let's get closer to the edge, to the water, before we do that. just say it.
Ax, you're up first.
I'm rowing. I'm rowing for everything I got.
All right, you get it about 15 feet. Which direction you want to go? You move your character, I'll move everybody else on the boat.
I'm moving towards shore, whichever direction that is.
Toward your left.
Uh-huh.
That's why I put you on the right. To your left.
Okay. Okay, so what? This way?
That way. 15 feet ain't that far, bro.
Okay.
15 feet right there.
It is, in fact, right there. All right. Moving Kami right there, and I will move this right there. All right. There's an action. What do you want to do? Bonus action. It's not to row further.
Dang it.
Damn.
Give me 1 second, guys. I'm gonna. Or not. All right, never mind. Keep going.
Other than that, let me double check something. I'm gonna put mage armor on myself.
Okay. Go ahead and take the spell. Do what you need to do.
All right, and let's see. My AC is now 14. And that'll be it for me.
Very well. Kami.
How far away is the creature?
Not very. Not at the very start. Like, it was literally in front of you as you guys started pulling away. So you guys are pretty much where you guys were right there to begin with.
I'm going to take my rope out of my bag and tie it to the back of my kunai. And
about to go boat fishing.
I am going to throw my kunai at its mouth, trying to get a tooth. Essentially, I'm fishing for a tooth.
So here's what I'm gonna do. I'll give you guys this set up. I'm just putting it on the map right now for you to be able to target it.
My God.
It's actually behind you, but since I can't actually put it off the map, right? Go ahead and throw your kunai.
Okay. 13.
13 does not hit.
I'll take my bonus action to reel that fucker back in.
All right.
That's it.
Very well. Samael.
Rowan.
Row, move your 15 feet. There's your action. Decide what you want for your bonus action.
That's all I got. That's I can't do anything for bonus action.
Very well. I'm moving the boat. I'm trying some new things than just regular D&D play. Kane. You're muted.
I'm going to look at Arashi and ask, do you want me to shoot or row?
She's ignoring. Orange.
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah.
Sorry,
pay attention.
So confused.
Pay attention.
I am. Yeah. No. So. Shit. That's a great question. What would you want to do? Do you want to shoot or do you want to row? I know you're asking me, but I want to take into account what you're thinking too.
Well.
Somebody has branch attack. Somebody doesn't. At the DM, I'm just going to say that.
No, yeah. I know he does. So fuck it. Yeah, you go ahead. Attack it. Why not? I'll row.
Okay.
And Irina can. Yeah.
I'm going to move my hunter's mark onto it, and I'm going to take a shot at it. With the heavy crossbow.
Get him, King.
Oh, nice.
Very nice.
Sweet.
Let's go.
Bring me the damage.
There is no Colossus Slayer, though. It hasn't been injured yet.
Has not been injured. That is 15 points of health.
And the Hunter's Mark damage.
Got this.
Okay.
And I guess that ends my turn.
Very well, then. Arashi.
I'm rowing the fucking boat.
Go ahead and roll where you want. Move this thing out of the way.
Alright, you said it's over here, right? Like, the shore's this way?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Then I'm just gonna... Oh, wait, 15. Ugh! Yeah, I'm just rowing this way.
Well, Irina, she's gonna do the same thing, except she's gonna row a little.
Depends on it.
Except she's gonna row a little differently than the rest of you guys.
Irina, what are you doing?
Probably zigging and zagging.
Getting. The only answer you get is getting away from them. She's putting distance between each of the groups as opposed to literally parallel racing.
Dude, I'm trying to get out, but I'm like...
Alright. He's joining the initiative order. Woohoo! You guys are lucky! You guys are lucky! Alright, he's back here. X.
Rowan.
Row it is.
And that'll be the end of my turn.
All right. Kami. He's in correct placement now, so.
Okay. I have to untie the fucking kunai and attempt to tie. I'll attempt to tie it to my crossbow and try to shoot at it and aim for the mouth again.
So be it.
22 to hit.
22 definitely hits.
There's no sneak attack on this. 7 damage.
7 damage.
And bonus, I'm just going to try to yank it and see if I can get a tooth to come with it.
Does not.
Dang it.
There is a specific health that I have in mind for this to actually be able to happen. Alright. Anything else you want to do?
That's it.
Semi-O. He's like a fucking rowan.
No. I'm gonna shoot it.
So be it.
Guiding bolt. Go for at it. The second level.
Go ahead.
21 to hit.
21 definitely hits.
14 points of radiant damage.
14 points of radiant damage.
And then I'm gonna grab that rope and pull too. See if I can give him some help on yanking a tooth out.
The arrow will come out, but it's not attached to a tooth.
Damn it. Sorry, copy.
Yeah, you did get some damage though. And the next attack roll made against the target for the turn has advantage thanks to the mystical dim light glimmering. You see this thing kind of light with an or kind of an ethereal light a little bit. Kane.
Do you have a rope I can use, Arashi?
Yes, I do. I will give you the rope. It is, how long is it?
50 feet, I think.
I think so. Yeah, it's 50 feet. I will give it to you. Do I need to take it out since I'm giving it to him? That's a stupid question, yes.
I mean,
I'm just for now, he could just add it to his, whatever. But yeah, here you go. I'm going to give him the rope.
All right. I'm not going to use it quite yet, but I am going to take another shot at this guy with the crossbow. So I'm guessing he doesn't look hurt really yet.
You have advantage.
Okay. You do have advantage.
I do.
Yes.
Oh, excellent.
Because of his guiding bolt.
Are we still blessed?
Nope.
You are not.
Nope.
Okay.
This has been way more than a minute.
Yeah. Well, that's it for my turn, I guess.
Arashi.
Who can make ranged attacks again? It's Kane.
Irina does have a crossbow.
Yeah, but she rowing, bro. She ain't gonna stop to attack this thing. Kane.
All of us over here can use a crossbow.
Okay. So yeah, sorry, I'm gonna take my turn. I'm gonna cast Bless on you four. I don't know why it's making me roll for it, but yeah. So on X, Kami, Kane. I mean not Kane. Sam and Kane. Irina just rolled.
Are they within range of it? How long is it? 30 feet.
Shit.
The only one that is currently within range is X.
Yeah. Damn it, I forgot.
She was not trying to do all that. Like, Y'all were the ones that started rolling first, all right?
Hey, actually,
I pushed you within 30 feet of each other.
Can I hold that bless for next turn? And I'm gonna row. If it's not, it's okay.
You can.
Okay, cool. Yeah. All right. I'm gonna row 15 feet.
This is gonna be really funny because she's gonna go the opposite direction.
I swear. I know. I'm like, Irina. I'm gonna look at Irina. I'm gonna be like, please, just row straight, just this one time, and then you can do what you want. I need to give them blessed. I need to bless them.
Okay. Is that where you want to be?
Yeah.
All right. Now, are you taking your bonus action?
I don't have a bonus action.
Very well, then. Irina is just going to let it drift a little bit as she drops the oar. She turns around with her fucking heavy crossbow and says, fuck this.
Oh, shit. Okay.
She's not going to row. She's going to start firing. She's going to fire two shots.
I didn't know she's fired. My bad.
Unfortunately, both of them will miss.
Damn.
And with that, you'll find out if this thing can do real damage or not.
Oh, hell no. Oh, hell no.
What the?
It's exactly 60 feet as it will use its full range of movement, swimming speed. You just see it dive under. This thing is a water creature.
You said it wasn't diving under.
It's not diving under. You just see it kind of fucking... It's on the top, okay? It's skimming the top, all right? But it's still a water creature. It's a fucking fish! It's a big-ass fish!
It doesn't look like no big-ass fish I've ever seen. Well, the artwork, but that's beside the point.
X, you're up first.
Alrighty. That
came it.
To me? No. Yeah.
No? Okay.
Nope.
Does not hit. I'm moving him out of the way for just a minute. Irina? Sorry.
Oh my god.
24 definitely hits. Ow. She makes the save, however, but nice. She does take 15 points of damage.
Hey, Rashi, punch that motherfucker in the mouth.
Well, I can.
I need to see. Just... 10 feet. With where it's standing. All right, 1, 2, 3, and 4.
Wait, he has 3 attacks? Oh, fuck.
All right, that is to you, Arashi.
I figured. I'm ready. Oh, it does not. It does not. Yo, let's go. Let's go.
Very well.
Let's go.
This thing is here. Go ahead.
Okay, I was going to say, before we go any further, how are we going to do the movement attacks? Like, if we try to row away from this thing, does it attack everybody in the boat, or is it just person closest to it?
We don't know yet.
Okay. Well, that's why I was trying to ask.
Oh, I know. I know what you were trying to go for. I'm just telling you that I'm not, as a DM, fuck around.
You're
and
not
find
giving
out.
Me the information.
Fuck okay. around and find out.
X, don't row. I have a plan.
Okay, that was what I was just about to ask.
Attack this fucker.
Somebody's gonna bite it.
Alrighty, in that case, we are going to... Um,
Sorry, I'm looking up something. Make sure I don't. Nope, can't do that. Yeah, I can. Okay, I'm going to cast Frost Fingers. He needs to make a con 13 save throw. And I was going to angle the cone so that he's just in it. Because it is a cone attack.
It is a cone attack. Got it.
Yep. 15 foot cone attack.
I'm looking up a couple of things real quick, making sure that I have this actually set correctly.
Okay.
Saving throw. All right. I'm saving throw coming in. 21.
He takes 2 points damage.
2 points of damage.
Cold damage. So if he's...
Oh. Disregard that.
Okay.
Can you read it fast enough?
I'm going to try to forget I saw that.
I saw that.
I saw part of it, but...
I'm not
playing this thing to full advantage because it's a baby. I would have fucked you guys up if I was playing this thing fully.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
All right, he took the 2 points of damage.
Okay. Other than that, I really can't do anything.
Very well.
So I'm done.
Kami.
Sam, X, which one of you stronger?
Him.
I've got 0 pluses.
I've got a negative 1.
All right, well, I'm tying one end of the rope to myself. Around my waist. Arashi.
Yeah.
Catch. And I'm going to throw the other end to her.
I kiss that shit, right? Right?
Sure.
I pull out my 2 kunai. I run off the boat, jumping in the air, and skewer it in the sides towards the head as much as possible.
I'm holding on to this rope tight as fuck.
Okay, all right.
What do I need to roll to make that happen?
No, that's not what I'm thinking. I'm thinking about something else here. Just give me a minute.
I have a plan.
Good.
You're,
I hope so.
You're actually doing what I was thinking about doing.
If you need a quick break for a second, your DM needs to look something up.
Okay, I'm gonna go
back.
Good.
All right,
you're
right
back.
Oh boy, here we go. That moment that shit hits the fan. And cards start getting rolled.
Damn it! I didn't get it.
All right, let's see here. It's here somewhere. Where am I looking? It's here and here.
Try this again. Come on. Are you serious? I'm gonna fucking sleep.
What are you doing over there?
I was trying to roll a card for Kane with a DC 12 and I got an 11. Because I don't have any modifiers because my sub expired.
Bro, you are so lucky.
Okay.
I had to read. All right. You can take your attacks, bro. Are you trying to grapple it?
I'm trying to hang on to it. It's not, I'm not trying to impede it in any way.
Okay.
I am just attaching myself to it.
Got it. All right. You can roll me attacks. Let's see if you can sink the kunai in.
Okay.
To see, we're going to create DCs, because obviously if you're jumping in to try to hang on, you're definitely trying to bury these things in, right? So let's see.
I'm hoping my body also helps give it a little momentum.
I get you. Let's see what you got for your kunai attacks here.
All right. Please be good. First one's not good. 11.
Does not hit.
Second one. 19 with the proficiency bonus taken out.
Yep, 19. 19 will hit.
Okay, so I hope one so. Kunai in him.
All right, roll your damage.
13, I would get sneak attack too, so 13.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, you would. 13. That is now this number. Okay. And you're hanging on for the moment. We will find out when he starts trying to pull away whether or not you continue to hang on or not.
Oh, no.
Yep.
All right.
Can I do anything else, or is that like the full turn?
Well, that would be your action.
That was like the full turn.
Yeah, that's your bonus action and action. That's two separate attacks, so I don't know what else you would really do.
Okay, then I'm good. I mean, I can bite him. I'm not good. I don't need to.
You should still bite him, just because he's going to bite you.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, Cappy.
Yeah.
Can you make a DC 14 con saving throw for me, please?
Well, I didn't bite him yet.
I know.
Okay, okay. DC 14, and I got a 14.
Very well. So be it.
So I'm not biting him.
No, that's not what I said. This is what you realize when you get on him, right? You thought that he was slick with water.
Oh my god.
You are riding on top of him, and he's slick with a type of mucus. That he is much like the frogs were. It just leaves a slime that seems to dissolve in water. But given that you're on not top of his ass, it may not be the greatest thing.
Okay.
And with that, we move to Semi-El.
I need a charisma saving throw from this thing, DC 15, as I begin casting a spell.
I did not make this creature up, so don't yell at me for any of these rolls. It's not my fault.
He fails. He now takes a D4 on anything he does off of his roll.
So be it.
And that is my turn.
So be it.
Yeah.
Kane.
All right. Using that rope I just got from Arashi, I'm going to hang on to one end and try to throw the other end to Kami. See if he can't tie this thing up some.
Okay.
You can try.
What do you want me to tie it to?
I know exactly what you should tie it to.
You should tie it to one of the That's what he's trying to tell you.
Yep.
Is that what you want me to tie it to?
Yeah.
I'm gonna let you right know right now. That's going to be very difficult.
I'm just saying to him.
Either that or tie up his fucking tail and we could try and drag him.
I picture him like on the his upper back. But
the big old tail in the back.
I can try to tangle up some tentacles.
Yeah.
So, roll me a survival.
For me?
Yep. You're the one trying to
nope.
To do this.
Hmm.
Yeah, no. You know that rope that you did have, RJ? Bye bye rope.
No.
Bye bye rope.
Fuck. I'll have to buy you another one, Rush.
You rolled a nat one, bro. I can't. There's nothing I can do about that. Bye bye rope.
At least it wasn't for the rope I'm holding him with.
True.
All right. Did that take my action or
we'll
bonus
say
action?
Your bonus action. How about that?
Okay.
I won't take your action.
Then I'm gonna take a shot with my crossbow at it.
Can I yell to him?
Well, we were already talking, so what did you want to say?
I say try to anchor it higher up his back so I can use it as a post to climb up towards his face.
Okay, but 12 didn't hit anyway, though.
Unfortunately not.
But yeah, I'll try to do that next time I sink one. That's it for my turn.
Okay. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I shall cast Bless.
I guess I'd be like here.
Yeah, so I'm giving Bless
to... I'm just gonna move him out of the way so that you can see.
Okay, so Kami, Kane, X, are you attacking or rowing?
I was rowing, but now I'm attacking. Because I was told to stop rowing.
At least okay, that cool. Turn. At least that turn. Okay. You can row if you want now.
Okay, X, do you think you'll be rowing more or not? Because I'm picking between you or Irina right now.
Do Irina.
Okay, Irina is semi.
Alright, so we have Demiel, Blessed.
Yep.
We have
Kami,
Blessed.
Irina,
Blessed.
Kane.
Got it.
Feel the holiness of Tyr.
Very well then.
I'm gonna motivate them. Let's go, guys. Y'all got this.
Is that your turn?
Yeah, because I have nothing else to do.
Well, with that, Irina is gonna drop that bow. First things first. For a minute, the knight can utter a special command or warning whenever a non-hostile creature that it can see within 30 feet of it makes an attack roll or saving throw. The creature can add 1d4 to its roll, provided it can hear and understand the knight. A creature can benefit from only one leadership die at a time. This effect ends with the knight's attack. All right, everybody. She's going to recharge your spirits a little bit here. The next time that each one of you, basically, you all get 1d4. And spawn.
Dang. So 2d4.
Okay. She's going to try to help you guys out. And then with that, she's going to take a couple of swipes at this thing.
She can add her d4 to both. Let's go. Nice.
So a 13,
nice.
A 17. A 13 does not hit, a 17 does in fact. So, she will do 6 points of slashing damage onto this thing. Alright, that will be her turn as the Aboleth. First things first. Two, three, four, five, and six. Two, four, and six. X, you are two. Fire, my friend. I'm gonna try to hit you. He's gonna nat one it though.
One.
I critted a couple times, but we're not running on others, so you know it's I'm gonna roll 2d10.
Stop nailing me or avoiding everything I throw.
Alright, so that was a 9. With a 9, Misjudge timing, opponent gets a reaction.
Punch it in the dick.
You get a reaction. You get a free reaction, Liz.
Is it close enough for me to...
It must be an actual reaction.
Actual reaction. Well, I don't need to cast a shield right now, so...
Punch it.
So you can do an attack of opportunity. It may not be a lot of damage, but could be something.
I'll do an attack of opportunity. So let's see here. We'll throw that. Looks like an 18.
18 definitely hits. Roll me damage.
Okay, what's that, a 1d4?
Yeah, probably. All right, you can just hit the roll damage button right there on the right-hand side.
1d4.
Four points of damage. It tries to hit you with a tentacle. You just reach up with that large freaking hand of yours that you got and just... punch that shit back down.
I mean, I do hit dragon claws, so, you know.
There you go.
But I'm not adept at using them.
All right, so that first one, so that was the 4, so it's going to be Irina, and then it's going to be Kane. So Irina gets the second.
Minus a d4.
16 doesn't hit anyhow. And last but not least, Kane. I don't think 15 hits anyhow. All right. That'll be its turn. Other than it's going to start, like, it's gonna basically turn is the best way for me to put it, right? Since you're on its back, grasp onto this thing, it's just going to turn kind of in place. I need an athletics check against his athletics check, or dex if you want it, acrobatics if you really want your choice.
Yeah.
I'm setting your DC of 23.
Minus a D4.
Minus a D4.
Oh, does it matter?
He gets 24. Doesn't matter. Is that just saving throws, or is that...
Everything.
That's just saving throws, isn't it?
No, it's everything. Attack rolls, everything.
Attack rolls or saving throws. Target must roll from an attack. No, it's just attack rolls and saving throws. I literally just read it. Attack rolls, saving throws. Alright. Axe.
Alright.
Rolling low for you guys on these attacks, man. You don't want to see the damage when it hits.
Okay. Kami now, like, towards the front of the boats, or is he now towards the back of the boats?
So Kami is right there.
Okay, so nope, I can't do that. Okay.
He's technically not on your boat at all.
Right, no, but I just needed to know which direction he was for, because I have, like, two things gotcha. I can do that are cones. And if he's where he's at, I can't do it because I'll hit him, which I will not do.
Okay.
In that case, let's do... He's like 5 feet away from me, right?
Yeah, this thing's right up next to you.
Okay, cool. Then,
just remember, ranged spell attacks, because he is so close, are done at disadvantage. Any ranged attacks are done at disadvantage. Now, I will say, if you want to do a cone, given that you can put it downwards, you can get it so basically, like, your hand's directly on top of this fucking thing, where you're not hitting Kami, and just aim it straight down.
Okay.
And you should be able to do a cone attack that way. I'll give that to you, because this is a 3D
actually,
space.
No, I'm not going to do that one. Okay, so, okay, I start waving my hands. I'm going to cast a spell. It's a cantrip. He needs to make a dex save 13. All right,
dex save coming in. Nine.
Okay, he will take... 3 points of acid. And no, it doesn't continue. And
technically, you'd be washing it off right now, anyhow.
Yeah. he's in the water, so I figure, yeah. So, yeah, 3 points damage for me, and I'm done.
Very well, then.
Unless I can still roll 15 feet.
No, you use your action.
Okay, no problem.
All right, Kami, you're on top of this freaking thing.
Am I, like, next to his mouth?
I mean, you can try to be.
All right, I'm going to dig in my kunais, like, climbing up him to get next to his mouth. So, first kunai coming in, natural 20.
I'm going to move you up this way so that you can say you're pretty nice. Damn close. Nat 20. All right, let's see that. Give me the damage. And add all that sneak attack, bud, because I know you're. Yeah. I know you got it. And with 12. A crit, that's going to be ridiculous.
So 12 base, and then it's a D4 plus.
It's 11 base. Hold on, 11 base. God damn it! Stop doing that. 11 base. Sneak attack damage is 2d6, right?
Yep.
Normally.
Yeah.
But then you add 12 on top of that. So that's an extra 17 damage on top of that.
Okay.
This is really going to start pissing me off. Give me a second. I gotta pull up the freaking calculator because at this point.
How much damage do you say it's gonna do?
The sneak attack alone did an extra 17.
So 12 plus
I got it.
17.
I got it.
29.
It's because I'm subtracting his health down as I go.
Yeah, but you should be able to now, if you type it in chat, you can probably also do this as click on it and maybe. Add damage.
No. It's fine. Don't worry about it. What I will tell you, Cappy, is as you are going in, that kunai comes striking in. You hit one of its three eyeballs, and you see it just start squirting just this ooze and pus out as effectively it is bleeding.
Nice. So I'm closer to its head now?
Yes.
I want to jam my second kunai into its mouth, into its tooth. Yeah. Like at the base of a tooth.
Okay, let's see what you got.
That's gonna be 16 plus bless. Plus her d4 that she gave me.
You have two d4s.
Yeah.
Nice. Okay, so make sure.
So 19 to hit.
19 hits.
And this is just the kunai damage of 8.
Nice.
8. Very well then.
Did I get a tooth?
You have not gotten a tooth yet.
Okay.
All right. With that, and the effect that it is actually technically bleeding at this point, I need. What Dredd's been waiting on this whole damn time. First of all, I need a DC 14 con saving throw from you, Cappy.
Yep. 13 plus bless. So get it.
Make it.
He just made it with that. Very nice. As you can feel this mucus trying to get on you, man, but it's not doing it right.
I'll take the mucus damage anyway. I don't give a shit. Nope, get this fine. Fucking tooth.
As you're doing this thing, I need three individuals. And we're going to find out together who those are going to be. One of those isn't going to be it. Two, three, and four. X. Kami. Irina, I need wisdom saving throws from each of you, please.
Oh, no.
Wisdom?
You gave her bless, right?
Yeah.
Very nice. She will pass.
I got a 15 with the bless.
You will pass.
I'm not even going to bother rolling.
No.
X, you will fail. As you see this thing kind of rear up, you hear the voice in the back of your head.
Save me.
As you are charmed by the Aboleth. Or by the Gitrog, sorry.
Same thing.
You are under the Aboleth's control and cannot take reactions, and the Aboleth and the target, we can communicate telepathically.
Oh boy.
You, my friend, unless they can take this thing out, are on the DM side.
Yeah. Oh, God. Okay. Yuck.
Semi-L.
Uh-huh. We're gonna move up to it. I'm going to touch it and can murder it, hopefully.
Nah.
All right. We will do things together.
That's 43 points of damage.
All right. You will kill it with 43 points.
But I want to make sure I get a tooth out before we kill
it.
Before it goes
away.
Yeah,
he's digging the tooth out, so we'll do this. What I do need from you is a Constitution saving throw, please. All right, so here's what's going to happen. As you reach down, it only had 30 points of health left. If you reach down, your hand touching it, black just tendrils start like creeping away from your hand all around this thing. You see just this, its skin just turning to mush and just broken pieces as it finally does reach the mouth. As Kami's trying to dig out this tooth, all of a sudden it gets really easy because all that necrotic has just turned this thing into just this pile of goosh and mush. Kami, you're in the water at this point, but you are currently tied with Arashi pulling you. Arashi, I need an athletics check from you, please.
You've got it, Chief.
Can I give her help?
At this point, you're not in combat, probably. I would say yes.
Okay, yeah, I need the help, so I'll roll one more time.
Okay.
Nat 20!
So, the good news, Kami, she pulls your ass into the boat. No problem, bro.
Nice,
you're good. You're holding the tooth. You're triumphant, my friend. All right? The bad news on the other end. Let me just make sure.
Here comes another one.
Semi-L.
Mm-hmm.
Are you immune to diseases?
No.
As you feel like you've done this and you pull your hand away, your hand stings and it starts to creep up. You're just like... You start gasping for air. Seems you're having an incredibly hard time breathing.
Did you touch the mucus?
He did.
I want to cast lesser restoration on myself and cure the disease.
Very well. Go ahead and take the spell for our spell.
I did.
As if you had not, I would have been rolling a d4, and for that amount of time, you would have only been able to breathe underwater.
Is that affecting me too?
It does not. You did not actually touch in any of your things. You used cones and ranged attacks,
no,
which is why
I did punch him, and he did charm me.
The DM forgot about it. Let's just. The DM forgot about the punch.
That's good, because that's one of those saving throws that you made out of freaking nowhere that I can take off your tally. Yeah,
I'm,
no, I haven't forgotten about those.
I'm going to misty step back to my boat.
All right. You can misty step back to your boat. As you guys all start to look around, you see a few more start kind of floating around to you. What are you guys doing?
We're dipping.
Rowing the fuck out of here.
Rowing the fuck out. As you turn around, as you do make it to the front, we are at time and we will end the session with seeing an as seeing one of these Gitrok or Gitrogs. Except it's not a baby. You see the mouth come out of the water, and all of you hear scream in your head. You've killed my children. And we will figure out exactly what it is that
you
want to do.
Weird way of using plural for singulars, lady.
You're going to hear Samuel L. yell back, like, you tried to fucking kill me, so fuck off.
All it wanted was a little bit of food.
Yeah, well,
eat it next
I'm
time.
Not food.
Exactly. All he wanted was a tooth. He could have left us alone and we were just taking a tooth.
I did not play this thing to its fullest capability in any way, shape, or form, bro. That would have been crazy. Oh. This thing has lair actions, legendary... I was like, nah, not a level 4, he don't.
As soon as I got that tooth, if she didn't get me back, I was literally going to take a potion of gaseous form and just 10 feet at a time float my way to the beach. I got 8 hours to make it there as a little ball of cloud.
You're a son of a bitch for leaving me behind, you.
I would have. I would have left all your asses, been like, go row. Go, go, go.
You guys were able to, I think it's 138 points of damage or something like that, that you guys did.
Mm-hmm.
So, the good news, it may not be the big Gitrok tooth, but you do have a Gitrok tooth.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
So, you are halfway to the requirement set on you by the hags. We'll figure out exactly what it is that you guys want to do next time. Do you want to stay and fight Mama? Or do you just want to dip the fuck out?
We're dipping the fuck out.
Hell yeah.
I didn't want to fight the first one.
Getting out of town.
All right. All right, everybody. I appreciate you guys coming and hanging out with me. I appreciate you guys for playing. It's nice seeing you guys again. You're nice and lovely faces. We will pick this up next Monday. I've got some weird stuff going on in February. We'll talk about off stream. So hopefully it should not affect you guys in any way, shape, or form. But I want to be completely transparent with anything that's going on. All right.
Okay.
I think at this point, we're going to raid the Mandy. Looks like she's playing some D&Ds. Or she's setting up some D&Ds. Is she playing D&Ds?
D&Ds.
She's setting up. Let's do Magi or the Magi RPG. Looks like she's actually playing some D&Ds. So. Alright, ladies and gentlemen. We'll catch you next time. And have a happy new year.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Later.
Have a good night. Bye.